Our Game of the Week is made possible in part by Palermo Pizza, serving the community since 1962. Family owned and operated. Online at palermo-pizza.com. Palermo, home of the 24-inch pizza.
Well, good evening and welcome to WKTV Sports. I'm Ron Schultz. I'm alongside Mark Bergsman tonight, and we are excited to bring you high school football tonight. We are at the Falcon Stadium. We're on the campus of East Kentwood High School, where the East Kentwood Falcons will play host to the Bulldogs from Byron Center. Crosstown rivals tonight, Mark.
Yeah, they're neighbors, and even though this is a non-conference game, it should be a good one. A lot of pride on the line here as the teams kind of get charged up for the conference season and for the real important games that come along later. But we got a perfect night for football here.
It is. It's perfect. And these teams, this is a final tune-up, like Mark says, before conference play starts. It's going to be a difference between two different styles of team. Byron Center will come in here. They're going to concentrate on running the football. A week ago on their first night, they had about 450 yards of offense. 380 of it was on the ground.
That's
what they're going to do. But when they did go to the pass, they were very effective. You go to the other side, and along Byron Center too, very experienced. You got a lot of players on there. This is their third year on the varsity. They're an experienced team. They're a playoff caliber team.
Yeah.
But so is East Kentwood. East Kentwood comes in. They got a veteran quarterback in Casey Joppy. He's been a three-year starter, and he comes behind an offensive line that's solid, led by, on the left side, the Granderson brothers. One plays left tackle, one plays left guard. So they're solid. They're big. They'll come with a different attack. They attack with speed. They'll look to throw the ball probably 25 times tonight. Their offense is more balanced.
Yeah. It should be a nice contrast in styles, and I think we'll see a really good hard-hitting game. I really think this is a great way to kick off the WKTV season.
It's a great way to start it because we got two teams that, Mark, I expect both these teams to be in the playoffs at the end of the season. But that's why a game like this is important.
It is. It is. And again, they're neighbors virtually, and so there's some pride on the line too.
Yep. So again, beautiful night for football. We're looking forward to a really, really good football game tonight. So sit back, enjoy. We'll be right back with the opening kickoff. This is WKTV Sports. Welcome back, WKTV Sports. You're getting a good look here at Falcon Stadium and the marching band of East Kentwood High School. I've just spelled out EK on their beautiful facility here as the Falcons get ready to take the field. Exciting night for football. It's beautiful weather. It couldn't be better. We got a matchup here that these two teams really match up well, Mark.
They do, yeah. And as you said, the weather's perfect. We've got a nice breeze blowing into the press box here. It's a cooler evening, but nice and sunny. And East Kentwood's band is impressive, isn't it?
It always is. Year after year, they do a great job of their performance. They look really good out there and did a great job with the national anthem earlier tonight.
Yeah,
already
just a well-drilled outfit.
Yep.
And Byron Center has taken the field and to much celebration over on the far sideline, and now Kent was just about ready to take the field. We're just moments away from the kickoff on this interconference game. White versus red.
Yep, and both these conferences are really solid in football. We'll talk, especially the red. East Kentwood comes in the OK red. They got a couple of the top teams in all of the state of Michigan, let alone in just West Michigan. The Caledonia Fighting Scots, the Rockford Rams are ranked early season, ranked right at the top of their divisions. And so Kentwood's there's never a week off in the OK Red.
No.
Because you've got Hudsonville is in there along with West Ottawa. Solid teams, Jenison. So you better become prepared. So this is a good matchup. Byron Center is an outstanding football team. We talked about in the opening. I really feel that they're a playoff caliber team.
Yep.
They got a ton of experience. We were down on the field and we were walking next to them. They're a lot of size on that Byron Center team. And like I said, they bring in a ton of experience. There's a lot of third year varsity players that'll take the field for Byron Center tonight. So
And as you said before, in the OK Red especially, you don't ever take a week off. The competition is the toughest in the state, really.
It is.
In the OK Red. And the White's not far behind it. And so these two teams should match up very, very well, size-wise, speed-wise. A little contrast in styles, which is always interesting, especially early in the year. They're about ready to determine who's going to receive this thing, I think.
Byron Center gets the ball first.
Okay.
I think they might have won. All right. I think East Kentland might have won the toss and deferred.
And deferred,
we'll
yeah.
see here. So I believe that that's what's going to happen. So, again, this is just our first night here at WKTV. We have got an outstanding lineup for you all season long.
We'll
bring in some of the finer football teams here in West Michigan.
Yep.
We get the opportunity to watch the South Christian Sailors and the Wyoming Wolves and just the list. So stay tuned week in, week out as we cover West Michigan's finest high school athletes.
Kentwood, Godwin, Kelloggsville.
Kelloggsville, yep.
See, we even have a drone on the field down there.
At least till kickoff, then it's not legal. So kicking off, Kentwood will take the – and they want to avoid what happened to them in week one, Mark. Kentwood kicked off to Heartland High School, and they promptly returned it 95 yards for a touchdown. So I'm going to guess that special teams had a little extra work this week.
You hate to start your season that way on the very first play from scrimmage. But Ryan Moore is going to kick it. He's a senior. And we're just about ready to kick off the WKTV football season.
So back deep to take this kickoff is number 23, Blake Otto. He's going to come this side. He's got a little seam, got a block. Breaks it out. And he's up at the 36-yard line, and that's where the Bulldogs will take over, and their offense will come onto the field. An offense that put up 55 points a week ago, and with a pretty much a running attack, Mark. They kept the ball on the ground for all but basically four or five plays.
And that usually sets the pass up, and they were successful on, I think, the four out of four that they threw.
Yep. Landon Tungay is the quarterback. He wears number four. Otto in motion. He's got the ball. Going around the right corner. He's got the corner. Good tackle.
Yeah, good tackle that time on the outside. He still made 5 yards on it, but that could have been a much bigger run.
Tackle by number zero, Stellan Bowman. We'll talk about him all night long, Mark. He's one of the stellar, solid parts of this defense for the Falcons.
Yeah, you need that side-to-side speed from your linebackers, and he just displayed it there. Lateral speed.
So a gain of five on first down. Again, Tungate in the shotgun. Looks, hands off, he's going to throw it out here. To quick pass, good play. Yeah.
Good solid tackle that time on number 13.
Will Lake.
Receiver Will Lake, but coming up to hit him is number four, I believe.
Yeah, Shamer White came up and got rid of the blocker and tackled for no gain. Great play, great defensive play. So White on that tackle. Makes it third and five. Surprised me a little bit that Byron Center came up throwing on the second play of the game.
Well, that's probably why they did it.
That's number two.
Scott
Lasky around the corner. He's going to have a first down.
Yep.
Yes.
Out to about the 46, 48-yard line.
Luke Lasky with a student body left.
That time he did make the corner.
Yep. It'll be first down. Ball's on the 48-yard line of Byron Center. Again, out of the shotgun. Going to be back to pass. Looking over the middle. He's rolling. Got an open receiver on the side, but he's out of bounds.
Yeah, he was out of bounds. And that's a flag because he was the first person to touch the ball after he came back into play, into the field of play.
Yep, Isaac Lee out there just kind of lost his sense of where he was on the field. He was so open.
Yep.
That
he was literally standing on the sideline, and then when the pass came to him, he stepped back into the field of play, and that's a no-no.
Yep.
Penalty will be assessed against Byron Center. Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what you call that infraction.
It's illegal participation because he basically is an ineligible player. It's a big penalty.
It's a big one, 15 yards. That's going to hurt. Now you're really behind the sticks.
Yep.
They keep first down, but they added 15 yards to their destination.
She got two wide receivers out. It's just going to be a quarterback keep right up the middle. Stuffed in the middle. It's going to pick up 3 yards. So Landon Tungate just kept it and went behind the left side of his offensive line.
I think he's trying to fool them. Well, they did. They have passed twice already, so I guess something to that fake.
Nua Deontay, number 57, was on the tackle, I believe. One of the many Falcon tacklers. Again, he's a rollout here. He's going to throw back. He's got a couple of blockers. Good defensive play. Yes.
Yeah.
They got rid of the defense, but tackle came up 33 with the tackle. Champ Henry, but it's going to pick up just a couple of yards. Make it third and 18.
Yeah, Terrence Cabanda, number 32, was up there stuffing that hole, too. A linebacker for Kentwood.
Well defended.
Yeah, what do you call on third and 20?
You probably, if I'm an offensive coordinator, I might look for something over the middle, because even if maybe you pick up a penalty, we'll see what they decide to do. Going to be a delay of game. So it'll back them up 5 more.
So penalties have really derailed the Bulldogs in this drive. And now they face a third and 25.
Now you reach deep into your playbook.
I think they're just going to try to get some yards back and punt, truthfully.
So they bring two receivers here to the right, or the short side, or the wide side of the field here. I look for him. He'll probably roll this way. It's just to be a handoff.
Yeah.
Something up the middle.
Yeah.
Safe. He goes to Laska. He just picks up a yard or two.
Yeah, safe play. They weren't going to risk anything on that one this early in the game.
They've stopped the clock for some reason. Not exactly sure why.
So that'll bring out the punter.
Back deep for the Falcons is number 13, Gabe Wolf, along with DeSay Gordon. Good
Luke
punt.
Luke Laska, the punter.
It hit a Falcon.
Oh, it hit a punt and
it
picked
did.
Right up on the fly. Number 20's got it. Wow.
Okay, the ball came down, hit a Falcon on the fly. It was picked up by Eli Farrell, and it'll be Byron Center ball on the East Kentwood 18-yard line. Big mistake.
That's a special teams boo-boo there by East Kentwood. You don't ever want to be hit by the punt if you're on the receiving end of things, and that's exactly what happened, and alert play by the Bulldogs as they picked it up in stride and even advanced it another 10 yards.
We can't there's got to be a delay in the game because the chains aren't set. So I'm not sure you can advance that. I think the rule is that where that ball is picked up is where the ball is dead. I'm not sure you can advance
They're coming
that.
Back with it. Yeah, you're exactly right, Ron. They're coming back with it, and they're going to mark it
at the 29.
Right where the player.
Yeah, the ref's going to explain it here.
Possessed by the kicking team. It's first down for Byron Center at the spot where the kicking team possessed the kick.
Yep. That's correct. Right. That should be the right call.
Excellent call, Ron. You picked that right up.
So Byron Center comes back on offense. Two receivers here to the wide side. And in motion is Otto. Ball's going to come this way. He's rolling out. He's getting chased from behind. There's a throw. He's open. Ball's caught. Steps out of bounds at the just inside the 20-yard line. Reception made by Isaac Lee.
Number three, Isaac Lee. At the 19, they're going to spot it.
So Byron Center's come out, Mark, throwing the ball a lot more than I expected. Here's a look at it. Here it just rolls out. He's getting chased from behind. This is a good pitch and catch right here.
Yep.
They tried to run that play earlier. And so Lee's been open a couple of different times.
Yep.
They must have found a little break in that in the films this week. So now he's going to roll the other way, running the same play the other way. It's Lee again. He's open,
and
wide
he's
open at the five, makes one move. Fumble!
And recovered by Byron Center. Recovered by Byron Center at the four-yard line.
Good hit stuck on Lee again, but he was open. Just did a little move over there. Ran the very same play, just ran it to the other way.
Yeah, mirror image of the play before.
Here's a look. Here's where the ball gets knocked out right there. Bowman knocks the ball out, but Johnny on the spot.
Get that number. I think it was number four.
I think it was the quarterback.
Yeah, I think it was actually number four, Landon Tungate, that recovered
Who
that.
Who covered it?
All right, first and 10 from the four.
Now we'll see if they go to their running game. 22, Zylstra in motion. Pilot, Kentwood just stuffed that play. They might have gained a yard or two down to the 2 yard line, but. Good play by the interior of the line. I think Byron Center is just going to do the same thing, Mark. They'll just pound it.
Yeah, I think so. At the 2.5 yard line, or 1.5 yard line, they're inside the two. So second and goal.
So Tungate's got Laska beside him to his left. That's Zylstra in motion. He's just going to quarterback keep around the corner.
He's got
and
it.
In. Touchdown. He fumbled.
They said he crossed the line. The official over there is holding up both hands, and they said he crossed the line.
It's a touchdown.
Yep.
So we'll get a look, I'm sure, here. See if we can get a look back at this. As soon as he crosses the line, the play is dead. So here's a look. So he's going left, comes across the line right there.
Yeah he's in the
red. It's
hard
to tell.
Yeah. I think he was in the red.
The official was right on top of it. So for the extra point is
Dawson
Hillard, and it's good. So just like that, the Bulldogs capitalized on a Falcon mistake.
It's one way to continue a drive when you have fourth down and 25 yards to go. You kick the ball and recover the fumble.
You kick it off the special teams player.
Yeah,
I don't think that was the plan in the scouting, but they'll take it.
Byron Center showing some spunk here. Early passing attack and surprised us and scoring quickly.
So I would assume right here, Mark, on this first adjustment, East Kentwood's going to pull their defensive backs together. And they're going to have to bring up the coverage a little bit. Otherwise, I think Mr. Lee there might pick them apart all day.
Yeah, both times the quarterback rolled towards the receiver. And I think drew up the coverage to himself and left the receiver wide open. So good calls on those mirror image passing plays.
So Dawson Hillard's got it teed up for the Bulldogs. Back deep for the Falcons is, see if we can get him. I believe White is one, and that's who it's going to.
So it's White coming right up the middle, right up the middle. He makes one miss. Brought down. Touchdown saving tackle, J.J. Lennon saved a touchdown. It was number 14.
Over,
take that back.
Over midfield.
Amon Edmonds is the return man, and he just didn't waste any time, north and south.
Some speed on that run.
So he sets his offense up in great position. This offense come out led by Casey Choppy, veteran quarterback. This is his third year as a starter. This young man can play football, Mark. We've had the opportunity to watch him over the last couple years.
And he's got some speed on the outside.
Yep.
Empty backfield.
Got five wide receivers. Good block. Throwing over the middle. Oh, he threw it.
Almost intercepted. Number 23 had it in his hands.
Blake Otto had it. Here's a look. Let's go back to that kick return right here by Edmonds. Look, he doesn't waste any time. He just goes north and south, makes one move. And I'll tell you, this tackle might save a touchdown right there.
Yeah, they teach that, don't they, in kickoff returns, go north and south.
That's what they want.
Yeah.
So Kentwood again escaped right there, had a turnover, but dropped by Otto. So again, five wide receivers, inside handoff to Jones. Jones coming left, makes a cut. He's going to pick up
six yards.
Nice carry by Jones. Jones, a week ago, led this team in rushing, 132 yards rushing, marking a touchdown a week ago.
Yeah, that's a nice night. Elijah Jones, you could tell he's fast the way he hit that hole.
So it's third down and short. He's got three receivers, tight end. He's going to look to throw. He's looking over the middle. Throws it back. Good catch.
Yep.
Down to the 30. First down. They'll move the chains. Reception right there. Number 11. DeSay Gordon.
Andrew Croft on the tackle.
Nice pitch and catch. Kentwood's moving the chains. Here's a look at it. They're going to go. It's going to throw right in your pocket. It's a good catch right there.
Yep.
So Kentwood, on their first drive, got Byron Center backed up. Boy, Byron Center had a chance.
Yeah, that interception was right in his hands. He's gonna be
thinking about that one in his
dreams. Yeah.
So Joppy looks over the defense, man in motion. It's Jones right up the middle, cuts back. He's got an opening. He's in the open. 5-4, touchdown.
Just like that, number 20.
Eliza Jones makes one move and goes north and south. Just like that, the Falcons answer the Bulldogs with a score of their own.
Well, just like the kickoff return, north and south all the way. You're going to see some really good blocking right there on 42. Took that player out of the equation, and the rest is up to Jones, and he does it.
Jones
right into the end zone.
Jones could have drove his Honda through that.
Yeah, that was a beautiful blocking scheme and a beautiful run that time.
Ryan Moore steps in and finishes up with the extra point. That's good. Just like that, we're tied 7 apiece. Good job by that offensive line by the Falcons.
Sure was.
Impressive drive. They got a break by the drop thing and capitalized.
Yeah, that was a big, big break because that could have been a real momentum builder for Byron Center, that interception that wasn't.
Yep. So Kentwood will give the ball back and see if they can come up with an answer to try to stop. They had them stopped. They had this Bulldog team stopped in the first drive, got a penalty, but then the Bulldogs kind of got their break.
Yeah, they did. This could be an interesting game. It's shaping up to be a real slugfest here. If the first two possessions are an indication.
Good teams. This is good football. So Ryan Moore steps up.
It's opportunistic football.
Yep.
Both teams taking advantage of big, big plays.
So again, back for the Bulldogs, it's Otto and I believe it might be Lee, and it is?
21.
21. Brings it all the way out to the 23-yard line.
It's Carter on the return. Carter Ahern.
So, nice return. Brings his team out to the 24-yard line, and that's where the Bulldog offense will take over. Landon Tungate brings his team back out. His offensive line, Mark, big guys.
Yeah.
They're big across that front offensive line.
They
the
are.
Opportunity to be down there. A couple of veterans down there. Joel Perez, he's a three-year starter.
Yeah, he is.
He's a big guy down there. Ben Kitchen plays the right guard. In the middle 58 is Hunter Steinbergen. He's the center. And we'll get to the rest of them across that front line. They're just a good offensive line. Otto in motion. He's going to throw again. He's wide. Oh!
Oh, and they're going to say he went high.
He's going to go high.
Yep, they're going to get a 15-yard penalty for hitting the quarterback high in the helmet area.
Yeah, it's going to.
I'm sure that's what the call is going to be.
They're looking at who is the blitzer coming in on that?
Yeah.
Well, here's a look at it. It's
number
24.
33. Was it 24?
24.
Okay.
Yeah, and he hits him high, helmet to helmet.
Yep.
Yep.
24 is the
Conda.
Yeah, it's Conda.
LSA Conda.
Yep.
Yeah, blow to the head.
Yep.
Yep.
Will he be ejected? That's the question.
I don't think they do it in high school.
Don't they?
No. But it's 15 yards.
It's going to be a first down.
And from that replay, that looks like a pretty good call.
Yeah. 39-yard line will be where Byron Center sets up shop. After the penalty's assessed.
Boy, I tell you, if that blitz wouldn't have come, they had a guy breaking down the middle wide open.
But that was a well-timed blitz. He just went high on him.
Just went high, yep. So Landon Tungate's fine. He's back in there to that shot. Looks like there's Otto in motion. Here comes a blitz again on this side. Tungate's going to run away from the blitz. And he's only going to pick up 2 yards.
Yeah, not very far as he's going to run.
Good job by the defense.
Landon Tungate on the keeper.
I believe 51 is in on that tackle.
Brought down by 51.
Well, obviously, Kentwood has been preparing for that Byron Center running game. And so far, it's been the pass that's really been sparking the offense for Byron Center.
Quick hitter out there to Lee. He's going to pick up a couple of yards. It's going to be
about 4 yards to go.
Yep. Third and manageable. Third and four.
At the 46-yard line.
So this opens up a lot of different options for this offense for Byron Center. They can roll to the wide side. One of the plays in the warm-ups that they were watching, that's a they roll out there and the quarterback just keeps coming with it if nobody comes in the taxing. So that's a possibility. Number 9 comes out to this wide side. That's Andrew Croft. And Lee spreads out to the top side, to the short side. Tungate in the shotgun. Otto in motion. He's just going to keep it. Runs right up the middle. Ooh, it's going to be close.
It's going to be close.
Looks like they're going to give it to him. It's going to be a first down.
They're signaling for the chains to move. The interesting thing, Ron, is that in the pregame, we documented that last week Byron Center was a heavily run-oriented offense, and this week they come out pitching the ball.
Yeah, they're going about 50-50 on their plays here. And again, that's good coaching, just
it
adapting
is.
To what the defense is going to give you.
Exactly.
And we'll see some of the adjustments. Maybe Kentwood's going to have to come up and play. They have on this series. I've noticed cornerbacks are coming up a little bit tighter and making it a little bit tougher. They were giving them about 8 yards. Now they're giving them about 3. So, again, ball goes the other day. Different quarterback. Number 2 is Laska, going to pick up 3 yards. Number 7 is Alex Walbin is in at quarterback for the Bulldogs.
Again, Kentwood showing some good lateral speed there, shutting down the corner, really containing that sweep for a minimal gain.
So Alex Walbin stays in as quarterback. So they bring 2 receivers over here to the wide side with Lee and Conrad. Going to be an inside handoff. It's Otto. He's got breaks one tackle. He's outside. One-on-one tackle. Ooh. Runs over a tackler. Still on his feet. Battles it all the way down. He's going to be marked out at the 28-yard line. Nice run.
It sure was.
By Blake Otto. We'll get a look at that. Watch the inside handoff. It's a somewhat of a reverse. Inside handoff makes a good move right there.
Watch
this. Here's where he lowers the shoulder. Boom. Hello.
We had a chance to visit with Blake Otto's grandfather just before we came on the air, and he's over there cheering him on. He's one of our associates.
And good friend.
Good friend, Paul Cableman. And I know he's all smiles.
Oh, good play.
That was an excellent play.
Okay, so
number zero is Stellan Bowman.
Stellan Bowman, one of the stellar players. He's a makes a big one-hand tackle.
Yeah.
Watch this tackle. He just reaches out with one hand and pulls Walbin down. Grabs him by the shirt. I'm going by, and you're going down.
Yep. That's all it takes.
So it's a
loss of 10.
Well, not loss of 8. 8 yards. So it's second and 18. Again, looks over here. It's Lee again. Going to make a move. Can't break that tackle. But he's going to pick up 8 yards.
Yeah, he's going to pick up what he lost on the first play. And a few more to boot. Leave about a third down and 9, 8. A little more manageable. Excellent work by the folks in the truck to bring us these excellent replays. I know you're enjoying them.
So Alex Wobbin continues. Throws out here to the wing. Got a defense. Nice tackle. Nice open field tackle out there. Number 10.
Yeah.
I believe that's Gordon. Went out there one-on-one, made a tackle.
That's going to leave them about 5 yards short.
And I think they're going to go for it.
Yeah, I don't think that's within their field goal kicker's range at all. So probably they will go for it. That's the end of the quarter.
Yeah. So at the end of one quarter, good football game we've got going. East Kentwood Falcons 7, Byron Center Bulldogs 7. But Bulldogs are knocking on the door. We'll be right back. WKTV Sports.
At the U.S. Center for Safe Sport, we see champions everywhere we look. In every sport, on every court, we're building a foundation to ensure all athletes are safe, supported, and strengthened. At the U.S. Center for Safe Sport, ending abuse is not just our job. It's our promise.
Well, we're back as we look at the sidelines for the Falcons right there as they prepare for a big, big play right here. It's 4th down and 5. Need the defense to step up. We got a report from the sidelines of Byron Center. The reason Alex Wobbin is in at quarterback is because Landon Tungate's been getting a little bit of medical attention over there. And I think they're getting him back, trying to get him back on the field. We'll see if we can see him later on. So in the meantime, Alex Wobbin is the leader at the quarterback position.
Critical play here.
4th and 5. Zylstra in motion. Oh, and they got him.
And they did draw Kentwood offsides, and that probably is going to very close to give him a first down.
It
yep,
will.
They're moving the chains.
Yep, so the chains move. So the Bulldogs, again, now first down on the 18-yard line. The Falcons right now just got to try to get a stop, try to hold this to a field goal attempt.
Wobbin staying out there. Been a fairly hard-hitting game, wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah. Big play. It's some pretty good hits have been out there. So it's first down. Two receivers to the top. going to throw that way. Number six with a reception is going to pick up 5 yards. That's Conrad, Landon Conrad with a reception. Nice first down play.
Nice pitch and catch that time, Wobbin to Conrad.
That's a good play for Alex Wobbin to play, kind of gets confidence, some of those little easier throws.
Right.
Isaac Lee now comes down here to the bottom of your screen. That's Otto in the backfield with Wobbin, number 23. And that handoff goes to Otten. Otto, he cuts up the middle, gets down. He's going to be about a yard short first down, be third and one. Nice gain all the way down to the 9 yard line.
Otto is a nice looking all around player. He lines up in the slot. He can go in motion. He can take the handoff. He can receive passes. He's just a good all around
football player.
Offensive player, yeah.
And defense.
And defensive player, yeah. Yeah, Paul's got a lot of reason to be proud there.
Absolutely. Foot Byron Center splits Will Lake one way, Isaac Lee the other. In the backfield, Zlaska, it's a fake. No, he's got it. Cuts inside, makes one tackler miss, and he's going to have a first down, goal to goal on the one.
1 yard line, yeah. Touchdown saving tackle that time by number 24. That is Conda, but they are knocking at the door.
Yep.
Right on the 1 yard line.
So they got 4 tries from the one right here.
First and goal.
I'm guessing nothing fancy here, I have a feeling.
Shadows now advancing across the field and pretty much have taken up the whole field.
Luke Laska is now going to take a direct snap. Wildcat type offense, and I think Byron Center is going to take a timeout. I don't think that's maybe what they want, and they do.
Byron Center, yep. Their first of the half.
It's probably a pretty good timeout right there.
Yeah, it is. I mean, this is a critical point in the game. They're right on the doorstep. You don't want to make a mistake here. But so far, they've looked pretty solid in their balanced attack, running and passing. Byron Center, very impressive here. On the second drive, we're counting that first drive,
yeah.
Even though it was interrupted there with that punt.
But they were moving the ball well until they got that 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, they
and that
were.
Really
yep.
Set them back, and they couldn't. Really couldn't come back. Kentwood's defense was solid.
Yep. Great view here at Kentwood Stadium, Falcon Stadium. Just a beautiful place. I mean, this could be a college.
Yeah, this is one of the
college
Mark,
venue.
Mark, this is one of the nicest high school venues around. It's just a outstanding place to come and watch a football game.
It's an outstanding place to get in shape too. If you're one of the announcers that has to come up to the press box.
So Luke Laska is still gonna in the Wildcat, and he's just gonna take it left
and
walk
in.
Into the end zone. Yep. Touchdown, Byron Center Bulldogs.
Untouched, Laska. Very impressive drive that time, 4th down and 5, and they got help from East Kentwood on that penalty. They drew a Kentwood player offside, and that continued the drive, and the rest they did on their own.
So again, Dawson Hillard will attempt the extra point. Good snap, good hold, good kick. Just like that, 14-7. The Bulldogs come back and answer. So they'll be back to the Falcons. We'll get their hand back on the ball. Here's a look at this. This is just basically power football.
Direct snap.
Yep.
Get it to your running back, and he's untouched.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah, good blocking up front. Good look right there. I love that camera angle right there. You could just see the hole open right up for.
Great camera work, too, by our excellent camera people.
True. Yep.
Week in and week out, you're going to be treated to some incredible shots by our camera people and our replay people and our graphics. And, I mean, our whole crew does a great job. They really do.
So Hillard will tee it up. Back for the Falcons, it's Jones. And is it Edmonds? Jones and Edmonds are deep for the Falcons. Need a nice return again. That's what they're looking for.
Certainly have speed back there. Potential to break one anytime.
There's a low line drive kick taken by one of the up men.
Number four's got
it's
it.
White. Breaks one tackle. Oh, nice tackle.
Yeah,
good special teams play right there by Drew Belinsky. Number eight for the Byron Center Bulldogs. Held his ground, did a great job of special teams.
Yeah, and kudos to Belinsky on that play. Those special teamers, they're important. They are very important to the overall flow of the game.
Boy, I tell you, and it seems like over the last, few years, special teams has been more and more and more and more important each and every week.
Sure, yeah. Well, it was in that Kentwood run back.
Yeah, oh, yeah, saved a touchdown.
Yeah.
So Joppy back in the, looks back to throw over the middle. So the screen knocked down.
Oh, knocked up in the air, and a chance for Byron Center to jump on that ball. They couldn't quite get to it, but a delayed blitz that time. If we get a replay of that one.
Nolan Stubblefield, number 50, is one who broke that play up.
Yeah.
From this outside tackle position. Or end, I guess, defensive end.
Just hesitated a little bit and then went on the blitz and right in the quarterback's face as he delivered that ball.
Second down. Again, Joppy looking this way. No, he's covered. Second goes to the same receiver. Almost picked off. Yeah. Boy, he looked off the first one. It was a good throw. Great defense. Defense was made by number three.
Isaac Lee.
Lee with the defensive play. Here's a look at that first play. That's our, there's Stubblefield making that play. That was the play before. So now it's third and 10. Falcons looking, they really don't want to give the ball up quite this quick.
No, that could spell momentum for Byron Center.
Screen up the middle, but it's red.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, just blown up in the middle there, number 66.
If we get a replay on that one, you're going to see Byron Center start to rush the passer and then drop back. And they actually dropped back, almost the entire offensive or defensive line dropped back into coverage.
Here it is.
Shut that play down.
Here it is. Watch Bowden Hurley. He recognizes the play. See him get back right there. Breaks that play up, number 60.
That was a nice defensive scheme by the Bulldogs.
Good snap. Here's the first punt of the night. Oh, it's shanked. Oh, he didn't quite catch it. It's going to be a short field for the Bulldogs. It's going to be out at the 30-yard line. It's a punt of it'll go down officially as a 5-yard punt.
Oh, boy.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, he did one of those Australian moves where he ran a little bit to the laterally before he punted it and just didn't get his feet set.
Just got off the side of his foot.
Yep.
So that gives the Bulldogs a short field, and boy, that's just exactly what they wanted for their reserve quarterback, Alex Waubin, to come in with a short field. So again, he sends two wide receivers out. Got Laska in the backfield, along with Otto, and he's just going to quarterback keep it. He's got a blocker, makes one block, makes the corner, around the side.
9 yards.
Stellan Bowman runs him out of bounds. Going to be a 9-yard pickup.
Yeah, he made the corner. They lost contain on that one, and partly with speed and partly with blocking.
Tell you though, Stellan Bowman got over there in a hurry though from that linebacker position.
He did, but he's 9 yards down.
He came all the way from this side though.
Yeah, I know it. They have great speed in their linebacking core. But that time they did break that contain on the left side of the defensive line.
So it's second and one. Again, Laska's the lone setback. It's a fake to him. Quarterback keep, gonna get around the corner. He's gonna get the first down. So he's gonna pick up the 1 yard for the first down. The chains will move. A new set of downs for the Bulldogs.
Terrence.
So for the Bulldogs right now, it's just about moving the chains and building that momentum. That short punt set them up in great field position, and they are literally a first down away from goal to go.
Yep. So again, Alvin is going to get sackled, yep. Tackled for a loss that time.
Yep.
Tackles made by number 33. Champ Henry comes in and makes that play for a 2-yard loss. Nice play by Henry. Coming from that outside linebacker end position, stuff set up. So Wobbin's going to, it looks, the report says that Wobbin's probably going to be the man in charge here, as it looks like starting quarterback Landon in Tungate might be done for the night.
Okay.
Wobbin roll this way. Looking, Lee is open, steps out of bounds. He's going to pick up.
At the 10, he's going to be a half a yard short.
Yeah, he's going to be
complete to number 3, Isaac Lee.
Half a yard short, I think.
First down is the 9, so he's 2 yards short.
Runs out of bounds, outside the 10.
Should be third down and 2. Nice throw again. Boy, Lee's been open on that little, if we watch him on his route there, he's doing a hard jab and turning that out. And
Wobbin has found him.
He's found him, and so did Tungate before him.
Yep. Wobbin has done a nice job coming in cold.
Looks like he's more than up to the task.
I think so. This is a dream.
So it's 2 down territory. He's going to keep it. He's got a big haul. Up through the middle, down, all the way down to the 2. Just like that. So it'll be first and goal from the 2 for this Bulldog offense. So when they do that power run to the left, there's some big holes out there.
But when you're a coach in a situation like this, you got to hold your breath a little bit when your second string quarterback is diving across the middle like that with linebackers lashing at him.
So I'm sure the Bulldogs will come out with Laska
they're going to the direct snap.
Yeah, come back out in the Wildcat. Yep, and there he is. pretty much I think he can yell to the defense, I'm running with it.
Yep.
Here he comes. Good stuff.
And he's in.
He's in.
Yep.
So Luke Laska stuffs it in from the 2-yard line. The Bulldogs come back with another touchdown. Good run. Good hard run. He's a tough guy to bring down. Big bodied guy. Just like that.
The Bulldogs take advantage of the short punt and the short field and punch it right in for their, third score?
Third score. So Hillard for the extra point, good snap. Short kick, hit the upright.
Hit the upright, no good.
20 to 7
is our score. And we do have 6 minutes and 43 seconds left in the first half.
Good half of football, boy. Both teams, the Bulldogs have capitalized.
They really have.
A couple of miscues
by
the Falcons, and both times it's led to points, Mark.
Yep, they have. It's been a game of opportunism. Against special teams has entered into this big time. Kentwood's score came as a result of a long run back.
Yep.
And the punting issue for Kentwood led to the Byron Center's first score.
Actually, punting of the ball and receiving of a punt has resulted in the thing. But you see it at every level, Mark. It doesn't matter if it's high school ball or the NFL.
Oh, yeah, I agree.
The special teams are just huge. So again, Hillard to kick off. Short kick. It's picked up by White. Got a little seam. Brings all the way out to just outside the 35. They're probably marking right at the 35. So that's where Casey Joppy will bring his offense up, and Mark, he needs to bring his team down the field. They need some points.
Yeah, they need some first downs to start with. They need to establish a drive here and kind of assert their authority, reassert it.
Yep.
They do have the beef up front, and they've got speed on the outside. They've got an experienced quarterback. They got all the tools, but they got to put it together here. They need a drive bad at the end of the first half here.
It's Jones, breaks one tackle, two tackles, and running right on that left side behind the Granderson brothers, and that's what I would do too.
Yeah.
I'd give it to my best player, run behind my best lineman.
They get about 3 out of that one.
So Jones,
it kind of went away from him the last series, and looks like they're going to try to if they can establish the run a little bit, get that throwing game, because we know Joppy can throw the ball. There's no question about that. But we got to get Jones running. So he's going to be in the shotgun this time. Jones is to his right. They got three wide receivers in tight on the left. Inside handoff to Jones. He's going to get to the outside. Breaks the corner. Oh, good defense.
Yeah, sure
good
was.
Good tackle made out there by number six for the Bulldogs. Yeah. That's Conrad.
Good. Shut down that play very effectively after only a two-yard gain, and that leaves them with a little over 5 yards left at third down here.
Now, Conrad came up from his safety position to make that tackle. Got to think that the coaching staff's looking at that. Got a safety flying up making tackles. So it's going to be third and five on their own 40-yard line. Falcons come out with three wide receivers, Jones in the backfield next to Casey Joppy. Joppy surveys that defense, looks inside handoff fake. He's looking over the middle. Look, pitches outside. And, just a little over the head of Bowman. It's tight coverage out there, good coverage out there. That would have been a tough pass to complete.
It sure would have.
Joppy knows, just put a little too much air underneath that. We're going to see what Coach Tony Kimbrough decides to do. They're thinking about it.
Well, they're still in their own territory by 10 yards at the 40-yard line. That's a risky play at this point, and I think they're going to punt it.
Yep. I think this is the right move. Yeah. Try to flip the field here. You got 5 minutes to play. If you can flip the field, get the ball back.
They got to get off better than a 5-yard punt.
Okay, this is interesting. I've never seen this before. There's two punters in a punt position.
Huh.
So there's going to be a flight, delay a game. So delay a game, so they'll back him up 5 yards to the 35. And in the backfield next to the punter, which is Ryan Moore, stands Owen Vanderveen, who's also listed as a kicker. And they are standing side by side. Huh.
I smell a rat. Nope, he's going to kick it.
A blocker, good punt. It's a punt off.
And it's out of bounds at
about the 40.
Yeah, about the 38, 30, 39-yard line of Byron Center.
So we'll see if something happens with that.
Interesting formation back there.
It was. So, again, here comes the Bulldog offense back on the field, and we've been talking about their offense a lot this first half.
Actually, they've had the stronger passing game. Kentwood came in with the touted passing offense, but it's been Byron Center that's been lighting it up on offense through the air.
Yeah, and they've run considerably more offensive plays. They've really controlled the offense. So Wobbin rolls left. He breaks one tackle, but not the second tackle. Brought down out here by number four.
Yeah.
White.
Got a couple of yards.
Shamer White with the tackle. So they'll pick up two. Second and eight. Mark, I'm with you, though. As the quarterback keeps running out here, I don't know how deep they are at their quarterback position.
Right.
But
it's scary. I mean, it is when you're running that second string quarterback out there. And you don't know, I mean, the first stringer is on the bench with an injury.
Yep.
So
the quarterback keep again.
They're not afraid to run.
Oh, another nice tackle in there. That's going to be Bowman with that tackle.
Yep, that was a good play.
Saved a possibility of a bigger gain if he'd got that around the corner. So he picks up two more. It's going to be third down and six. Ball's on their own 43. Play comes in from the sideline.
Interesting to see if they go conservative here and just are content to punt it back to Kentwood, or whether they're going to attempt to pass here, try to pick that first down up.
They bring two wide receivers to the wide side of the field. Otto, the backfield along with Laska. He's going to roll that way. He's looking, throws one up. Lee all through his hands.
Right through his hands, but a nice pass, actually.
Isaac
on
Lee
the run.
Isaac Lee had a first down, but it went through his hands, and he realized, he's slapping himself. I got to catch that ball.
Yeah, I mean, the quarterback made a nice play on that. Wobbin rolling to his right. That's not an easy throw, and boy, it was right there.
So credit, good job by the defense for Kentwood. They get the exactly what we talked about. Yep. They got the field flipped.
Yep.
Back to return is number 13, Will Late. No, 13, Gabe Wolf.
The punt. Johnson.
It's a shorter punt. Oh, they get to Byron Center roll. It's going to roll outside right about the 20.
Yep.
So,
out of bounds.
Rolls out of bounds.
At the 19-yard line. So Kentwood's offense comes out. They got 3.5 minutes to play.
Yep.
Plenty of time to move down the field.
Plenty of time to move down the field and establish a drive and come away with some points. And they desperately need that right now. They need to get the momentum back on their side.
It'd be a big play for Kentwood. They will start with the ball in the second half.
I smell a big play coming up here.
So they send out four wide receivers with Jones in the backfield. The handoff is to Jones. He bounces it to the right, makes a cut, misses a tackle. Good gain. Going to get 15 yards on that first carry.
Yep.
15, 16 yards. He hits a 16-yard carry. So just like that.
He's a good-looking runner. Good blocking that time.
Oh, it's going to be running right in your living room. Watch him bounce it out here. Makes that one move, boy.
That
you don't
cut,
teach that move.
That cut gained him 10 yards.
So four wide receivers again. Same setup. Jones, inside handoff. Jones bounces left, but not this time.
Number 50 wrapped him up.
Yep.
That's
Stubblefield.
Nolan Stubblefield. That'll be a loss of a yard.
Nolan Stubblefield's made a couple of big plays for this Bulldog defense.
And he made no mistake, just bear hugged him to the ground.
Yep. Actually, they lost a yard on that. Again, same offensive set. Four wide, Jones in the backfield. Fake inside, he's looking over the middle. He's got a guy open, but a little short.
Yep. That was a deep slant route, not an easy one, and he threw into some coverage that time.
Gordon had got a step in there, but boy, he had to put that one on a dime to get that one completed.
Yeah, the Byron Center pass defense so far has been very impressive.
Very impressive.
Very impressive. They've had a near interception. They've had a couple of balls that have been deflected and knocked down. And very few completions for Kentwood. Very few.
Andrew Croft was on that defense for the Bulldogs. So it's third and 11. Boy, Kentwood needs a conversion right here. Got plenty of time. Looks over the middle. Ball's caught.
Yep.
And dropped.
And dropped.
And
yeah, I think it's a recovery for Byron Center. It is. They're signaling it.
The ball.
The ball was caught and then fumbled.
I believe it was Kate. Let's see. Holt, I believe, makes the catch. Makes a great catch here. Turns to go back outside. Defense is then made. Who's that number two? That's
two.
Laska.
Yeah.
Knocks it loose. Luke Laska locks it loose. Number three, that's Lee. Jumps in and Tries to cover. I think he got a hand on it.
I think he did. right at the sideline.
The official was right on top of the play. So
they're saying he corralled it.
So it's the 44-yard line of the Falcons that the Bulldogs take over.
Just over 2 minutes.
Again, looking to score quick. There's a wide open Lee.
Yep.
It's all by himself at the 20, 15, 10. Breaks the tackle.
He's in.
Touchdown.
What, just like that, one play. What do they say after a turnover? Go for the strike.
Boy, Isaac Lee makes the recovery. He got wide open. They got a mix up on the defense right here. We had one defender and two receivers. That's Otto, 23, was also open. He breaks that one tackle, tiptoes down the sideline, and just like that, the Bulldogs extend their lead to 26-7. Hillard looks to convert the extra point. Lee is holding. Snap down kick. It's partially blocked and hits the upright again.
A second upright. Wow.
So he's 2 for 2. And 2 for 2 with hitting the upright.
26-7 though. Ron, I want to go back to that pass play that scored the touchdown, because it wasn't a particularly well-thrown ball. The quarterback kind of lofted it up in the air, and it was a high ball, but there were two Byron Center receivers down the field, and only one defender, and basically the Byron Center receiver just could stand there and wait for it to come down. Well, that's Isaac Lee.
So the quarterback was saying he saw the pressure coming from the outside, Mark, and from that position when you're standing there,
yep,
and you look up and you see a receiver open and you know that you're about to get drilled.
Yep.
Your idea is just to get rid of it.
I'm just saying it was a kind of a lofted pass. It was not thrown on a rope.
No.
But it was a completion and a touchdown pass.
He probably was trying to decide which open receiver to throw it to. So Hillard knocks it back. Good kick back there. That's Edmonds. Going to come up there. Good job right there. Number 25 on special teams.
And that'll stop the clock with just over 2 minutes to go. That was such a quick strike. They took over the ball with 2 minutes and 17 seconds left, and that only took.
So here's the return. Zachary Weaver comes up, number 25, right there.
Yep.
Makes a good tackle on special teams. So now it's 2 minutes to play. And
that entire drive for Byron Center took 15 seconds.
Yeah, one play.
One play.
So we were talking about Kentwood trying to get momentum going into the half, and boy, it
backfired
in a hurry.
Yeah, that was.
That fumble, because they had a first down, Mark.
Yeah, it was a.
They'd have hung onto that ball.
It's a good pass play.
So Joppy's looking over the middle. First receiver going to step out of bounds, save a little bit of time. Reception's made out there by Gordon.
About an 8-yard gain. And that's what they need to do, is they need to go back to some simple pitches and catches and reestablish themselves in their passing game, because their passing game has been very flat in the first half. It's been very flat. Well defended by Byron Center.
There's going to be a flag.
Delayed.
Illegal motion.
Yeah,
illegal. He moved.
Yep.
So they'll back him up five. Had a little stutter step there. That's all right. Backs him up. Still second down. Now it's second down and seven. Kentwood still has, I believe, all three timeouts. So they got a lot of time. 2 minutes with three timeouts.
Plenty of time. They just need to settle down and reestablish themselves.
Pressure coming, throws it to the outside. He's got to get out of bounds.
That's a nice play by number two. That's Isaac, Luke Laskin.
Luke Laskin, we've talked about him all night, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. And he is a all-conference linebacker, 3-year starter, Division II all-region linebacker as well. So
he's got showing it tonight, isn't he?
He's got some credentials, and he's actually showing why he was voted such.
Yeah.
They have a solid team.
So it's third down. Going to roll. Good block. Buys him a little bit of time. He's open. Going to zip one over the middle. Oh, and
that was
boy.
That Isaac, was deflected.
Isaac Lee got a hand
he
in
did.
There.
Yeah, he did. And so did number 11. He might have touched it too. Thatcher Simon.
Good defense right there. So it's going to be fourth down. Boy, with a minute, over a minute left, you got to punt. And they are.
Yeah, they are.
They're going to punt it away.
It's fourth and five deep in your own territory, trailing 26-7. You got to get rid of that ball.
You can't. That with two timeouts that Byron Center has yet, you got to get the ball on the other side of the.
You can't risk it.
So again, both guys are back in the punt formation. I'm assuming that Ryan Moore is going to punt it, and almost got blocked. He gets off a good kick though,
just barely, and Lee makes a good sure catch on the other end. And
so again, 1:11 left with two timeouts.
Yeah, Byron Center's not in bad field position, 37-yard line.
I doubt they're going to sit on it.
I wouldn't.
No, I wouldn't either.
I wouldn't. If I'm coaching them, I'm going for the jugular here.
Yep. Especially with two timeouts.
Oh, yeah.
That's a ton of time. And remember, high school ball, on a first down, the clock stops. So every first down, the clock will stop till the chains are set. So they're going four wide receivers. We haven't seen a lot of this. Going to be a quick hitter. 13 sits down with it. Going to gain 5 yards. 13 is Will Lake. Right to the line of scrimmage comes the Bulldogs.
See, that's just a nice free 5 yards.
Yeah.
Boom.
Use a lot of time to get that. If you're going to throw that short one, you want to throw it to the sideline. Again, four wide receivers. And look, same play. Ball's a little underthrown.
Yep. He missed his receiver that time.
First one that he really did.
Yeah, those setting something up here, Mark.
Those throwing those little outs like that. Watch for that pump fake and Lee to be going down the sideline.
Yeah, the stop and go, or whatever you want to call it.
Out and down, whatever way you want to look at it. Gonna look, there's gonna be a screen over the middle. Good catch right there, 29.
Ooh, and he's close to a first down. That's gonna be about a yard short, or are they gonna say he stepped out earlier?
Vandenberg on that reception. That's the first time we've called his number tonight.
They're gonna say he stepped out a little earlier. So it's fourth down and about 3.5-4 yards. So they'll probably punt it.
Yeah. So of course, Luke Laska is the punter. I think he drove the bus over here and carried in the equipment.
I think so too.
So
you got to have one of those valuable do everything kind of players on your team.
Yep. Good snap. Kick is up. It's a little short.
Yeah, pretty good kick.
Bailing
not
out.
Bad.
Bounces back. Kentwood gets a good bounce.
They'll have it at the 34-yard line. Their own.
Now there's only 35 seconds left. Three timeouts. I guess you could take a couple shots with the timeouts.
Well, you could take the shots, but so far they haven't been too successful.
No.
Their passing game has been really non-existent, thanks to really Byron Center's defense.
Yeah, credit the defense.
Boy, they've been all over that passing game.
So again, Casey Choppy looking over the middle. Got an out receiver, looks back, got it. Up over midfield to the 40. Clock will stop. So we got 28 seconds, clock stops.
Yep.
Marked at the 41 of Byron Center, and I believe that they might use one of their timeouts. They have three, I would use one here. Here's the best throw that Choppy's thrown all night.
Yeah, it is, over the middle. He's got to be there, and he hits him in stride.
Yep, they caught the Bulldogs in a zone. Little zone coverage and found an opening in between the
nice little slant.
Zone. Yep.
Nice little slant. It was a nice pitch and catch that time.
So now, still two timeouts left, 28 seconds. If you can get something, step out of bounds. You still, like I said, you still got the two timeouts in your pocket. Score here would be huge.
Sure would.
For the Falcons.
Of any kind.
Coach Kimbrough's not thinking three, though, I tell you, Mark. He wants a touchdown here.
Well, that would certainly get him back in the game, that's for sure.
So trips down here to the short side, or to the long side, right up to the right of Choppy. Three wide receivers, one to the top. Shotgun, he's looking over the middle. He's got an open receiver. Good catch, down to the 14-yard line, wide open. Good throw, two good throws in a row by Choppy. They're gonna come up, the ball stopped. They're probably gonna, are they using another timeout? Yes.
Watch this throw
right there. You see how Choppy's throwing with a lot of confidence now. You can see him stepping, throwing that ball right through. Threw that ball on a dime.
Yep.
Good catch. Caught by
Kendrick New.
Yep. I think that might be his first catch of the night. Kendrick had a good night a week ago. He had 7 catches for 73 yards. But I think that's the first time we called his number tonight.
Well, the offensive line has been giving the quarterback, Joppy, a chance to set his feet and really step into his throws. And those last two throws have had some authority.
Yeah, he's thrown with some real confidence right there.
And they're both over the middle throws. So you better be accurate with those throws because those are the kind of get picked off.
But they found the openings in the zone. And they found that receiver. It looks like that's what they're trying to get. Trying to get in between the backers, the linebackers and the safeties. But I got to think Byron Center now probably come out man-to-man inside the 15. Yeah.
22 seconds.
Again, here comes a blitz.
Boom.
Oh.
And the ball's out. The ball is out. Oh, they're saying he was down. Boy, I don't know. That was a quick whistle because he got clobbered, and that ball was out as he got clobbered.
It was Blake Otto coming from the blind side. Here he comes, untouched. Here's
watch
a look
this.
At it.
Watch
boom.
It.
And he is.
I guess maybe they had a point. Maybe he was down, but it was close.
Close. But Blake Otto just came around the end like he was shot out of a gun, and he was untouched.
Yeah, blind side hit.
Ooh.
Boy, those are tough.
So, but when you empty the backfield like that and you're sending out four and five wide receivers, your quarterback's got to have that clock in his head, and he just never saw him. Coming from the blind side right there. Good play, good call by the defense.
Watch for Byron Center to do something like that again, maybe from a different angle, from a different side.
So
maybe a delayed blitz up the middle. But
they got to come with, the Kentwood then's got to counter that. They got to put one of these speedsters heading to the corner of the end zone here and just lay one up for him, let him go up and get it. I would think, who do we got down here on the bottom? We've got number 10. Johnson is down here along with, he's going to throw it in the corner.
There's another. Oh, and that, he got hit again.
Yeah, the defense.
He got hit again, and 29, I think, got him that time.
He had to throw that a little bit before he wanted
he
to.
He did, because that linebacker was bearing down on him. It was 29 Vandenberg that got him that time, just after he released the ball. But he felt that pressure and caused an errant pass.
So Kentwood's either got to get a first down, a touchdown, or something out of bounds now, because they only got 13 seconds and no timeouts.
And they've got about third down and 20.
Yep.
Third and 20 to go.
Holt down here along with Johnson down at the bottom. I got to think they got to go into the corner to the right here. Looks over the middle.
Nope. No good.
So we got time for one more play. Good play broken up by the Byron Center Bulldogs, number 3, Isaac Lee, with a breakup on that play.
He's had a nice first half.
Yes, he has.
Lee has had a nice first off on both sides of the ball.
Yep.
Offensively and defensively. Big play here, 7 seconds left, 4th and 19.
It's basically,
oh, they're going to try a field goal.
Okay, so they're lining up. This is a 40-yard field goal.
That's a major league field goal.
It's Ryan Moore. Casey Joppy's the holder. He was making them from here in the warm-ups. Snap, down, kick. It's up. It is.
No. Nope. Nope.
Short. Just a little bit short. So there's 2 seconds left. Byron Center to take over the ball. But, boy, I thought he had it.
I do. Yeah.
It was right on line.
It was accurate, just a little short.
Needed 40, got 38.
It's a little different when you're kicking under game conditions with guys charging in on you. And again, you know, Ron, this game has been determined to a big extent by special teams.
Special teams have played a big part.
Special teams have played a huge part in this with run backs and fumbles and interceptions. And just the kicking game has played a huge role in this. Byron Center probably just going to
take a knee
on this and head for the locker room with a very gratifying 26-7 lead over the East Kentwood Falcons. Yeah, they got the victory formation going.
I don't think it's a victory formation in the first half.
Well,
so that's like that. So they do take the final snap. Good half for the Bulldogs. They're going to walk in. A lot of confidence going in, Mark, with a nice lead. The Falcons going to need to make a few adjustments. But that last series, you could see Casey Choppy getting his confidence.
Yep.
They might have found a little crack in the defense, and we'll see if we can work on that.
Yep.
It's definitely a lot of football to play here in the second half. So, again, I hope you've enjoyed the first half as much as we have. We will let the teams go rest. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the second half of this exciting action. Again, halftime score, Byron Center Bulldogs 26, East Kentwood Falcons 7.
With love I will build a wonderful thing that makes this life better for you and for me.
Shriners Hospitals for Children has been creating wonderful opportunities for children in need. This life-changing medical care helps them do the things they've always dreamed of. To find out more, go to loveshriners.org.
Well, we're back as we get ready for the second half of this contest between the East Kentwood Falcons and the Byron Center Bulldogs. Both teams are back out, got warmed up. Falcons will get the ball to start the second half, Mark, and I think it's key for them to get on the board here maybe in this first drive.
Yeah, they have to establish something. They need to get a few first downs, number one, and establish a drive and then punch it in for a score of some sort.
Yeah.
Just to get momentum back on their side because Byron Center was just playing impressive on both sides of the ball in that first half.
Yeah.
They did a great job defensively.
Yes.
They shut down Kentwood's passing attack for the most part. There were a couple of glimmers of hope there at the end of the half, but for the most part, they were tough on that quarterback and made the throwing game very, very difficult. And they played good on offense, too.
Yep.
Really a solid first half for Byron Center.
And really, for as much as I would say Byron Center kind of dominated that first half,
the score
is still definitely within range.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's basically a two-score game.
Yep.
I agree. But Kentwood has to establish something here. They've been kind of pushed around a little bit in the first half, and they got to get something going.
So Hillard kicks off to the back to the Kentwood, comes up right up the middle. Pretty good return. Going to start out on the 30-yard line. Casey Joppy, who ended the first half real strong with a couple of real good throws, brings his offense back out. And this is, Mark, always one of my favorite parts of a football game is to see
the adjustments
that have been made at halftime. I always enjoy that part. We'll see what have, because defensively and offensively. But obviously we saw in that last series of the first half that
He has an arm,
and he might have found a little crack in the defense for the Bulldogs.
Hit a couple of nice slants there, about 10, 15 yards down the field, yeah.
So he comes out, four wide receivers, Jones in the backfield with him. We've seen this set up a lot. It's going to be a handoff to Jones right up the middle. Oh, 10 yards right now. Good pickup, good start. Yeah, actually nice, going to give him 11.
Nice six, burst off from right guard, and that guard tackle hole there, and up the 10 yards in a hurry.
Tackled by the safety for the Bulldogs. Conrad's might have saved a touchdown, Mark.
Yeah. Well, they got to get that offensive line going for East Kentwood. That they pride themselves on their offensive line, and they got some big boys up there. They need to create some space for the running backs and some protection for Joppy.
Like he's changing the play. Yep. He was changing the play, and they're going to have to use a timeout. The play got in a little bit late. There's a touch of confusion there.
Yeah.
And then Joppy was trying to change the play, it looked like, at the line of scrimmage, and they just ran out of time.
Well, the last thing you want to do here is get behind the chains on an important drive after you've just made a first down. You don't want it to be first and 15.
And you show how important this drive is because Coach Kimbrough was willing to use a timeout right there.
Yeah. And this gives Byron Center a chance to just kind of reset themselves too.
It's really one of the first times Jones has got, he hit the afterburners right away, didn't he? Boy, he was into the backfield.
He was through that hole in a hurry. Beautiful evening here in Falcon Stadium.
Kevin comes out, three wide receivers. Again, Jones in the backfield. That's Bowman in motion. Going to come back this way. It's the inside. Jones bounces it outside. He's going to get about 4 yards on that carry. It's a good first down play. Up to the 45.
Brought down by number two, Luke Lasko.
So Bowman comes out, the extra wide receiver comes in. They'll come out with four wide.
Yeah, they like that four wide look.
Yep. So in the backfield with Joppy this time is number 24, Conda. Elize Conda. Looks to throw over the middle. Oh, and he threw in a pick.
Yeah, he did.
And that time.
And guess who got it?
Yep, that time Blake Otto did not drop it. Looks like a little miscommunication. And Otto read the quarterback's eyes.
He sure did. That was a really, really solid play by Otto. You'll see it here.
This is a great camera angle for this. Watch 23 come into your picture. He's going to come right there. See, and he reads the eyes.
Just stepped right behind the receiver.
Yep.
And I do think he controlled the ball, too.
Yep.
The ball did touch the ground, but he controlled it. And that defines an interception.
So the Bulldogs take over on their own 45-yard line, first down again. Alex Wobbin comes in. He's going to hand it out to Zylstra.
Zylstra went nowhere.
Nowhere. He's going to lose a yard. Tackle made out there by Bowman.
Brought down by Stellan Bowman.
Yep. Bowman with a tackle. Bowman's got to be getting up there near double digits in tackles, I think.
He's a solid linebacker. He's got good lateral speed. And
I don't know if we mentioned it earlier, Mark, but he's a verbal commit to the University of Ohio. He'll become played for in the MAC division with the University of Ohio next season.
That's awesome.
Good for him. Again, it's that inside handoff. Zylstra's going to bounce it outside. Breaks one tackle, gets around the corner, but no. He's going to get stood up, going to come up about 4 yards short, make it third down and four. Nice tackle made out there by Conda.
He just crossed the 50-yard line, and he's now officially in East Kentwood territory with about, as you said, about 4.5 yards to go for the first down.
They ran that play a couple times in the first half, too. They've run that play. Byron Center's run that play for years. That little counter type play. Two wide receivers. Man in the backfield. Fake to quarterback. Keep it. Going to get a first down.
Yeah, he is. Nice counter move that time. Had the flow all going to the right. He went to the left. Kept the ball. Fooled them enough to get 5 yards for the first down.
Move the chains. That's what Byron Center wants now.
Yeah, every time they move the chains, they get that much closer, not only to the end zone, but to the end of the game.
Yeah.
Keep that possession. And
this time it's Otto with a handoff, tries to cut inside. Gonna have a nice gain on first down.
Sure
pick
is.
Pick up 6 yards on
Blake
first
Otto
down.
On the carry. Brought down by 23, Cervantes Scott.
Ed Otto's an impressive player.
He is.
You just build your team around players like that.
Just like that, yeah. About. Here's a look at, there's Otto running that. Just running, putting both arms around the ball. Protect the ball. That's what you want to do.
Well, Byron Center's doing what we said they would do in the pregame.
Yeah.
And that is
run.
Ground the ball.
Wobbin again bounces outside. He's got a block. Going to be, oh, nice one-on-one tackle out there.
And I think they stopped him in bounds, which would be, well, although they'll stop it for the change of, yeah, the moving of the sticks.
First and 10 Bulldogs.
Well, we've talked since early in the game when Landon Tungate went down injured that we had to bring in Alex Wobbin, but Mark, he's playing like a first teamer all night, hasn't he?
He's done really well. Yeah, he's an excellent quarterback in his own right.
Yeah. So basically, it looks from what we can observe, and that's Wobbin carrying the ball for a couple yard gain. They basically have brought two starting quarterbacks into their offense right here.
They have not missed a lick
with him
at the helm.
No, he's done an outstanding job.
It's basically just been a really beautifully conceived game plan for Byron Center. They came out, and much to our surprise, they threw the ball around and successfully at that.
Yeah.
And now they come out with a lead, and they're doing what they do best, and that's grounding the ball, running it.
Yeah, moving the chains and burning clock. He's going to bounce that outside. He's quick. One side outside, boy.
Just short of the first down.
So it's going to be third down and one, maybe two.
But you know you're in four down territory when you're that far down.
Yeah. They have not had, Byron Center has not had a lot of negative plays
all night long, have they? Other than that, the one penalty that cost them the 15 yards and stopped their first drive, but then they got the ball right back.
And they've had a couple of plays where Kentwood has come in and maybe stopped them for a one-yard loss or no gain.
Yeah.
But they've really been pretty positive in their offensive plays. So it's third down. Otto in motion there, and I have a feeling that's which way they're going. Going to be stuffed. I think he's short, Mark.
He's going to be short. But, again, I would I would bet that they'll go for it here.
Here you could bring in the Luke Laska job for the Wildcat, or got a bunch of different options.
Lots of
here.
Options. This one, basically a yard and a half to go.
Yep.
And even if you get stuffed on this play, you're still taking time off the clock. And
they're on the ball sits on the 23. They're not going to
create any kind of special teams nightmare this way.
Oh, and they moved. There's a little bit of a breakdown. So now it's going to be
offense number 23.
Now we'll see if that changes their plans. That'll make it a third and seven, 6.5, 7 yards, fourth and seven.
Yeah. So see what play call comes in. Probably a little rollout pass run option. Give that quarterback Wobbin the opportunity to make a decision one way or the other.
Yeah. Now Kentwood's got to decide whether they're sold out to the run or whether they might pop a pass on them.
They're going to come out. We'll see what kind of pass coverage they're coming out. They're in man-to-man coverage, which pretty much means somebody's going to be on the quarterback. It's a rollout. He's going to give an option. He flips one down there. It's
got
caught.
It. Got it. Inbounds at the two.
Isaac Lee with another catch.
And a beautifully thrown ball on the dead run by Wobbin.
And that time he had to put a little air underneath it, Mark.
Did.
And he did.
He did. That was a beautifully thrown ball. He hit the receiver Lee right in stride, and wonderful completion that time, right down to the 2 yard line.
Yep.
Everything's falling into place for Byron Center.
Yeah, they're getting it. So this Luke is Laska is going to come in, and they'll go back to that Wildcat offense.
Yep. They'll take the quarterback out for his protection and direct snap.
Put in a bigger guy.
Yep. Got two big guys back there.
And Minato, I tell you, there's not a team in West Michigan that would take those two young men on their team.
No,
it's going to go to Otto, around the corner, and
he's in. He's in.
Touchdown. Touchdown.
Yeah.
Blake Otto.
Once he turned his shoulders, there was nobody going to stop him. He just plowed his way in there. And again, Byron Center capitalizing on that turnover, go all the way back to that interception, which Otto accomplished, and they've just marched methodically right down the field.
And used half of the third quarter in doing so.
I know it. And
so Hillard will try the extra point, low snap, Bucks gets it down, gets it up. And
it's good.
Good. Isaac Lee with a good job on the hold there to get that ball down. Hillard finishes it off and makes an extra point. 33-7. Boy, big opportunity again.
Yep.
Handed to the Bulldogs, and they capitalized
on
it
one
more time.
They did. I mean, they have been so impressive defensively, and the defense has led to offense. And they have, as you said, they have capitalized every time they have had a turnover or some kind of an opportunity. And
because of that rhythm, like that, you notice that Kentwood seems to, they kind of get a few things going, and they just can't establish something that consistent with their offense all night long.
Well, truthfully, Ron, what I've been as impressed with as any other phase of the Byron Center game is their pass defense. Their pass defense has been stellar all night.
Rock solid, yes it has.
And they almost had an interception in the first half. They did have an interception just a little while ago. And knocked down passes, pressure on the passer. I mean, everything they could do, they have done to make life miserable for East Kentwood.
But Edmonds drops the kickoff, but again, returns. I've been impressed with him all night,
too.
Yeah,
he's been good.
So he puts his team in good field position out at the 37. Good return. Again,
by young Mr. Edmonds. See if they can do anything with it. They're at 38, actually.
So here's it. He drops it.
Yeah.
Keeps his head. See, I like how he, look how he goes north and south. Boy, he's quick.
Yeah.
Makes a couple guys miss right there. That miss gained him, what, 10, 12 extra yards just by that little sidestep.
Yeah.
Good job by helping his team out.
Special teams plays a big role in every game, and it certainly has been the case in this game.
So, kind of comes out in, beside Joppy. The offense, that's where, fake handoff. Good pass,
ooh,
caught.
He juggled it, but he
hung
got
on.
It.
Hung on.
Joppy's Kendrick. Pass complete to number 8, Kendrick New.
Kendrick New is a, with
tackle
a
by number 6, Landon
catch.
Conrad.
Boy, good catch, too.
Very good catch.
Picks up 8. We second and 2. Okay, they come in with a little tighter pack. Look for a run here. Is it in the backfield with him? Is it Jones? Looks like Jones.
Ooh, and a good play by number 2. That is Luke Laska.
He just Elijah Jones on the carry.
Shut that Apple play down, two, short of a first down.
No gain. Looks like good. It's a whistle.
Sure tackle that time by Laska.
For some reason there's a whistle, there's a stop. Why is there a stop?
Now they're back.
Here we go. Big first down right here needed by the East Kentwood Falcons. There's confusion in the play.
Sure is.
They still got plenty of, they got plenty of time to play off. Now he's got his offense set. Puts Bowman in motion. Gonna be a handoff in the middle. Jones with a wide open. He's got a highway. He's gone.
Yeah, he sure is.
Down Falcons.
He fooled the Byron Center Bulldogs that time. Right up the middle. He only needed 2. He got what? Yeah. Once he broke that initial line of scrimmage, he was gone.
Boy, he's quick. We'll get a look at that again.
And that's exactly
here
what Kentwood needed, the big play.
Run right at, watch the opening right there.
Yeah.
He makes one move. That's all it took.
Yeah.
And then it's this speed that he's blessed with. There's no catching him. Good play by the Falcons. They're right back at it here. Plenty of time yet. Kick is up and good.
Yep.
So 33-14. A couple of scores. They need a stop. That's what this Falcon defense needs right now is a stop. Here's another look at it. You can see it opens. It's a
good
from
blocking.
The 45. It's a 55-yard run, roughly.
Good blocking that time. Number 8 and number 58. Really deserve a lot of credit here. Justin Negrin. And number 8 is Kendrick New.
Yeah, the wide receiver came in
both
and did
of them.
His job.
Both of them opened up a gaping hole, and the running back took advantage of it.
Yeah. So Kentwood will come out. Their defense needs a stop, Mark. We talked about that. A 3-and-out here would be big. There's 3.5 minutes here in the third quarter.
And
they
have not seriously been able to do that all game long.
No. No, they've struggled there.
Byron Center has had their way with them offensively basically the whole game. So we'll see, as you said, Ron, it'd be important for them to get a stop.
And of course, Byron Center is going to come in with that offense. They're just going to try to move the chains. They're not looking for anything big.
3.5 minutes in the third quarter. Kentwood's thinking another score here. Byron Center's thinking about eating up that entire 3.5 minutes.
Plus, it's a good kick. They take it on the 5-yard line, heads back to the middle. He's got no help. He's in trouble. Good job. And he's gonna get run out of bounds at the 7-yard line.
Yeah.
Great coverage by the special team, kickoff team of the East Kentwood. And there we talk about the difference, Mark, in the return for Kentwood running north and south and the running of east and west.
That time the punt returner had a decision to make because that ball was angling toward the sideline. And if it goes out of bounds, that's a penalty.
That's a big penalty.
And they get the ball quite a bit upfield. But he decided not to chance that and to play the ball. And he basically had no help back there. No blocking ahead of him. And they cut him off pretty good. 7-yard line.
So officially they put him out of bounds at the 8-yard line. So Byron Center takes over on their own 8-yard line.
See once what they can do with their backs against the wall a little bit here.
This quarterback right.
Oh, and he goes down. He's going to lose a yard. And he also looked hurt. His leg gave out underneath him. And that doesn't look promising.
This isn't good.
No, you see, watch here. Right there, his foot slipped. Either rolled an ankle or twisted a knee. One of the two, it looks like.
He's in pain.
And so now that worst case scenario that Ron and I talked about is very much on the table. What do you do when your second string quarterback goes down?
Now I'm not a doctor, but it looks like they might be checking for they're looking his leg over. So let's take a break.
Yeah.
As they attend to the Mr. Wobbin, we'll take a break here at WKTV Sports.
STEM is everywhere, like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead.
When we break down clothes, we tumble it with trisodium phosphate, rock salt, and dish detergent.
We stitched together images of our model and created a 3D set that can be walked through in a VR headset.
We're able to turn 12 walkers into 1,000 walker boards.
STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. What will you make with STEM? Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
Gotta go out for a play, though.
So we're back here. Good news. Mr. Robin is walking off under his own power. It kind of looks like he might be cramping up, Mark. It's warm enough now that he might be starting to cramp up. Look at the fluids in him. In the meantime, Byron Center runs out.
We're trying to see here.
Luke Laska is going to be the quarterback.
Yeah. The do everything guy.
So on that play, again, they lost a couple of yards on that play when he went down. So it's
second
down to 12.
12 yards to go.
So Luke Laska is going to try to, he's going to lose some more.
Yep.
He's going the wrong direction right now.
4-yard line now.
Play was made by Kentwood by, try to see what number made that nice play for a loss.
Well, Kentwood has the advantage at this point of having its opponent back against the wall and knowing that they're down to their third string quarterback and probably not going to pass it from that position on the field. And so they just threw everything at the line and managed to penetrate and make that tackle in the backfield.
So now it's third down, 14. Ball sitting on the 4-yard line.
They're going to be playing run again here, the Kentwood defense.
Oh, there's a flag. Delay a game.
Yeah.
So now it's half the distance. The ball goes down to the 2-yard line. Okay, this is a great confidence builder for this Falcon team.
It's also a real test for Byron Center, who has had really their way in this game up until this point.
Yeah.
Now they're pinned deep in their own territory and down to their third string quarterback. Maybe was that the quarterback that came back in there?
No, not yet. So a couple of negative plays. We just talked about that. Byron Center had not had some. Now Kentwood has forced a couple. Otto in motion. He's just going to run it this way. Up the middle, going to get whatever he can.
Yeah, he may have made the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Bowman with the tackle again. And the ball will come all the way out to the 5-yard line. So
they got to kick it. And Kentwood is going to come away with real good field position.
two return men back for the Falcons.
Johnson
is one, and the other return man. Wait, where's Red? It's 11.
11.
It's Gordon. I thought it was. So they're up inside the 35. They're set up inside the 35.
Yeah. That's about right.
That's blocked.
That's blocked back out of bounds. That'll be a safety. Yeah, it is a safety. The near side rusher went in unattended and
touched
and stuffed that.
Here's a look at
kick. Watch this.
I don't know what he's looking at, but the guy's coming right there.
Yeah. Nobody touched him.
20.
22. No, 20. I think it was 20. I think so.
But 21. Brown.
Okay.
Ethan Brown was the big play. So it's 2 points. What happens here? To explain it to you, that's counted as safety. Safety, here's a look at it again. Watch Brown come. He just gets pushed to the outside, and he just takes the great angle.
Yep.
He takes a perfect angle.
Yeah, he does.
Ethan Brown with a perfect play.
He's a tall kid, too, and that worked in his favor, but he had that punt stuck.
So because of the ball is knocked out of the back of the end zone, it's considered a safety. 2 points then is awarded to the East Kentwood Falcons. The Falcons also now will receive the ball. The Bulldogs have the option of either punting the ball or kicking the ball off conventionally like a kickoff. They have that option. So we'll see what they decide to do. But a great play by the Falcons. Boy, you talk about a momentum builder.
Yeah, this is a momentum shift in this game. That stand by East Kentwood holding Byron Center down there inside the 10-yard line and forcing that blocked punt and safety, that's huge. Even though it only results in 2 points, it's another possession for East Kentwood.
So again, Kentwood does need to score three times. They still trail. So they are going to kick it off conventionally. The kickoff, Hillard kicks off from his 20 instead of from the 40 like normal. Line drive kick. What happened? Something, I think, okay. Byron Center was offsides on the kick, which that stops the play. So now the ball will be moved back to the 15. Should be brought back to the 15. If they were at the 20. Yep.
That's
back to
exactly
the 15.
What's gonna happen.
And we'll do it all over again. Again, the penalty, you're not aware. The kicking team cannot cross that line right there, the 15, until the ball is kicked. And then it's just like an offside.
And Kentwood receiver at the 50 is sorry that penalty took place because he was off and running.
Yep.
And he had a lot of open territory ahead of him.
So here we go again. Squib kick. Back to him at the 50, same thing.
Yeah.
This is coming this side, needs a block. It breaks the tackle. Oh.
Now they're going to get him on the other side of the 50. Good special teams that time by Byron Center.
Yep.
That was an excellent play by number 8 among other people. That's Drew Belinsky.
Yep.
Called his name before.
Him and Carter, number 21.
Special teams again playing a huge part in this game, and that time Byron Center came out of that pretty good, really.
Yeah, they did.
Now we'll see what the Byron Center defense is made of, because Mr. Moe is definitely on the side of these Kentwood Falcons.
And Kentwood's got plenty of time. I'd be using Jones again. Yeah, try to get it. Ooh, there's a good
big
hit in the middle.
Hit.
But he bounces off it.
Yeah. And that'll be blown dead at about the 49-yard line.
Gain of 3.
Number 20, Eliza Jones on the carry. Stopped by number 50, Nolan Stubblefield.
Inside of a minute now in the third quarter as we count down.
So Joppy got 4 wide receivers looking that way. Quick hitter. Got a guy, steps still in bounds. Finally steps out of bounds. Number 11, Gordon. The nice catch. First down. Move the chains. So they'll reset the chains, but the clock will not start because he's out of bounds until everybody is set. And got the offense right up to the line of scrimmage. They're ready to go. Joppy calls out his offensive play. Again, Jones beside him in the backfield. Four wide receivers. And in motion. Gonna pit inside handoff. Jones is gonna pick up about two. Tripped up inside back there. Of course, again, Luke Laska is gonna be the guy getting off the bottom of the pile.
Chris Brown Jr.
1 yard gain.
20 seconds and counting.
They're going to get one more playoff in this quarter. They hurry.
Unless it's an incomplete pass. Now they come up to the line. There's inside of 10 seconds.
Sure he wants him to snap and get a playoff. Get a playoff. He's not going to make it.
Nope, that's it.
That's the end of the third quarter.
That's the end of the quarter.
Third quarter comes to an end. So a good quarter for the Falcons. They cut into this lead a little bit.
Yep.
And so at the end of three, Byron Center Bulldogs 33, East Kentwood Falcons 16. We'll be right back with the final fourth quarter. This is WKTV Sports.
Some chores you dread. You do them, but that doesn't mean you're happy about it. Then there's registering with the Selective Service. If you're a young man turning 18, the law says you have to register. It'll keep you eligible for college loans, government jobs, and training, and it only takes 2 minutes, which makes it not only your most important chore, but the easiest. When you turn 18, register at sss.gov or the local post office.
We're back as we get ready for this fourth quarter to start. Casey Joppy brings his offense up on the Byron Center side. Inside handoff, Jones makes a miss. He's gonna get push, still pushing, first down. All the way up to the 28 yard line. That moves the chains, exactly what the Falcons needed. Going no huddle, they really need to hurry.
Yeah, they really do. Time is definitely not their friend here.
They actually need three possessions.
Yep.
Two. Because two won't do it.
And they need to shut Byron Center down completely.
Which their defense did an excellent job of in that last series. Actually made them for negative yards.
Yep.
So Joppy, bad snap.
Ball's on the ground. And that's going to cost them about 8 yards.
So snap was just a little high.
Yep. That'll cost him some time as well. Back to the 34 yard line. Second down now in what? About 17, 16, 18.
So again, he comes out, he's got three wide receivers. Jones to his right. And they have Bowman in the slot. He's on the patterns as well. Looks over the middle, goes to the second choice. Good catch. Hang on, gonna be close to about the 23 yard line. They'll mark him. The 23, gonna be third down, five. Nice pitch and catch in there.
Yep.
Number seven on the reception. Holt, I believe, on the reception.
22 and a half yard line. 22 yard line, we'll say.
Again, in the hurry up. Joppy's changing the play. Bringing Jones back to the backfield. They're using a lot of time, Mark.
Yeah, they are. Down to 10 minutes.
Play clock's down to 5-4. He's got to get a stamp. Jones, hand up. Nice play.
Gets wrapped up.
But he still struggles. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage. But the initial play was made by Byron Center's number 59. I believe it's 59.
Either that or 50. One of the two. 59. You're right. It was 59.
Chris Brown Jr. with a big play.
Yep.
From the
one of the up linemen.
Yep. Turned that play inside, got a hand on him.
That was a very big play. He met the runner basically when he took the handoff.
Yep.
Huge play here, fourth down. And a good 4 yards to go.
Chappie looks right, looks right. Still good coverage. He got behind the coverage. He's out of bounds, though. He's going to be out of bounds.
No good. He's out of bounds. You're absolutely right, Ron. He caught it out of bounds. It's going to be Byron center ball.
Oh, they got he got behind the defense. There's a little stumble on the defense, but you'll see that I'm sure the replay will show his foot was definitely out of bounds.
And there are no reviews at this level.
And it didn't look like it was, it wasn't a clean catch either, so.
It was definitely an out-of-bounds play, and Byron Center is going to take over.
Take over, yep.
And on the change of possession, that was fourth down. So they went for the bundle on that play and unfortunately came up just a little short.
Yep. And that could be a big play in this football game right
huge,
there.
A huge play.
So, at quarterback, it's number 18 now. The ball's carried by number 40. I don't have a 40 on my roster. I'm sorry for that.
No, that means we can call him whatever we want.
Yep, I believe. So number 18 is now in at quarterback, and I don't have an 18 on my roster as well. So,
well, we'll call them by their numbers at this point.
I apologize to you young men, but
we're going by the guides they gave us.
Yep. So you're going to see them run the game clock way down and then snap it with just 2 or 3 seconds left.
That was a nice gain on first down.
Number 40 again.
Oh, look at this.
He rumbles and bumbles all the way up out to the 42-yard line.
He is
big
a
carry.
He is a
see
big.
See if I can hear from the PA announcer.
Stop by 13, Gabe Wolf.
If I can get a name on number 40.
He is a short, 42. Stocky kid and used his bulk that time to get low and just plow his way up the field.
Well, he accelerated quickly once he got the ball. He saw that opening and accelerated through it, did he not?
Yep. Where have they been hiding him all game? All of a sudden they pull out this new guy.
Fresh legs.
Key point in the game.
So Byron Center down to, I'm not sure what number quarterback, and he's doing a fine job. Fumbles.
Yeah, that was a great job by number 18 just to hold on to the ball.
Yep.
You don't want to turn the ball back over here. And they came very close to doing just that.
Mike Zua, number 99, was the big guy in the backfield to break that play up for a 5-yard loss. So again, Byron Center. So it's going to be second down and 14.
Yeah, something like that.
But they still got the ball. That's the key. So again.
Yeah, that was a good play just to hold on to the ball in that last play.
Again, here. Number 40.
And ooh, he gets off met. Yeah.
Nice play in there.
Right at the line of scrimmage.
I believe that's Bowman and who's in 33? Henry, Champ Henry,
yep.
On that knockdown.
Well, the good news for Byron Center is even if this drive goes nowhere, they have gained a first down and taken some significant time off this clock. We're down pushing 6 minutes now.
Even if they come up short here and East Kentwood doesn't use a timeout, it's going to be down near the 5-minute mark.
Yeah,
and
three scores. Yeah. That's a tall task.
So the quarterback keeps.
Yep.
Just a nice safe play.
Exactly right. A safe play.
But Kentwood does use their timeout, which I expected.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, they got to really hold it all out here.
So. Bainbridge is the quarterback. So we have a number 18 is Bainbridge. And the running back is Krause.
Krause. Okay, we got some names for you.
Yep. So Mark, I'm going to go under the assumption that in high school rules now you can use, call it kind of the five-quarter rule. There's some players, if they don't play a lot of time in the JV game,
yeah,
they're eligible to play a quarter or so in the varsity game.
It's possible. They could have had him on the sideline and just in case of just such a scenario.
And that's why they do this, because, you know, to help with the numbers situation, and a lot of schools don't have necessarily have enough players. But this way that they can feel the team. I'm assuming that, Mark. I have nothing to back
up. I think I think that's a very good assumption. Ooh, and a low line shot punt.
Oh, he fields it. Good play.
And he's down at the 42-yard line.
Amon Edmonds again with a nice return. Again, Mark, okay, a guy like Edmonds would be wanted on a lot of teams
around
the area.
And let's just take a minute, Ron, and there's a Kentwood player down now needing attention. Let's just take a minute here and say, for the sake of our Byron Center faithful and fans, we hope the best for number four, Landon Tungate, and number seven, Alex Waubin, the number one and number two quarterbacks who have been knocked out of this game. And kudos to the coaching staff for really managing under tough circumstances here.
Yeah.
And Waubin, I thought, did an excellent job coming in relief and engineered, three drives for him?
Oh, yeah. He played very, very well. And he may be fine. I see him on the sideline. I think that they're just
cautionary move. Yeah. And at this point, leading by three scores, why risk it if he's subject to cramps? Sometimes cramps come in series.
Yep. And it does give an opportunity for Mr. Bainbridge to get a few snaps
at that
varsity level.
That's true.
And that can be valuable later in the season.
We're speculating that he's a JV-er that they are pressing into duty. But anyway.
So Joppy back. Going to throw one up. Going to be overthrown. Again on the coverage, I believe that's Isaac Lee on the coverage.
Yeah. Good coverage. He was step for step with the Kentwood receiver. So
Isaac Lee, Mark, in 2022, he was an all-conference performer as well in the OK White. And that's obvious.
Yeah.
That's to see what outstanding talent.
They have some real performers on this Byron Center team.
This OK White conference is going to be an interesting conference a lot of good teams that play in this conference as well. Well, you say that with every OK conference in the area. Good pick.
Oh, right off his back shoulder, and he couldn't pull it in. So that's an incomplete pass. The good news is the clock stops.
Yeah. Well, right in and out of the hands of Mr. Holt. He'd like that one back because I think he might still be running.
We're close to the 5.5-minute mark, and Kentwood basically has to score here.
Here's a look at it. It's just a little bit on that back shoulder, but I'm telling you, Caden Holt will tell you I should catch that every time.
He turned to run with it before he had it.
Yep.
That's what happened there.
Third down and 10, four wide receivers for Mr. Joppy. Looks over, looks left, looks left, looks left. Throwing over the middle short.
Good and coverage. Again, excellent coverage by number nine, Andrew Croft, on that play.
He's played well tonight, too.
Yeah.
Andrew Croft's been very well out there on the outside for the Bulldogs.
This entire Byron Center defense has just been stellar through this whole game, especially the pass defense.
Well, last week they played a good Battle Creek Central team, held them 14 points. So.
Yeah.
Defense is to be reckoned with. The Joppy on fourth down, fourth and 10. Gonna run with it. Got a look. He's got throw. Now he's got a tuck.
Yeah,
now he's in trouble.
He's not gonna make it. And he run
out
of bounds.
And they're gonna get him for a late hit.
Yeah, I don't know about this. I don't agree with that call. He ran him out of bounds. Yeah, maybe he pushed him a little bit at the end. But at this point in the game, I don't know if I agree with that call. They're talking it over, but they're gonna march it off. It'll be a 15-yard penalty.
you're in full
under discretion.
You're in full stride like that, and you're running a guy out of bounds. You don't know where exactly where the boundary is. That's just my personal bias.
Yep.
A
little march off 15 yards.
And Kentwood keeps the ball.
Yep. A little over 5 minutes to play yet. Ball will come all the way into the Byron Center territory, out to the 43-yard line.
You know, I'm going to say Coach Mark Sisko for Byron Center there is not going to be too hard on his player in that case, because that was just a good defensive play that maybe got a little out of hand at the very end. But you don't want to short circuit your team's enthusiasm.
Yep. The play is stopped. The referees are on the wrong place. The referees have to switch positions. They got the back judge on the offensive side of the ball. He's now walking to the other side of the ball.
Minor detail.
Maybe the other. Yep.
Now we got the whole Kentwood team coming to the sideline.
Okay, here's what happened, guys. That was a dead ball. That was fourth down. So is that not an automatic first down? It must be not an automatic first down.
It must not be.
So it's a change of possession.
It's a change of possession. You're absolutely right. Byron Center's got the ball.
So the 15 yards.
How can that not be a first down?
I'm not sure. It's a dead ball, so I guess it would be a change of possession. So Krause with the carry picks up two. So because it was fourth down, once the ball was put out of bounds, they did not receive the first down. It's a dead ball. So then the play is, I don't know that I've ever seen that before.
I know I haven't.
So
anyway, that's,
forgive me for my confusion.
That's where we're at.
Well, that's why the back judge was on that side.
Yeah.
He was right and I was wrong. So
we're inside of 5 minutes and Byron Center's liking the change of possession. Second and eight.
Quarterback keeper right up the middle. Again, it's just going to be pretty conservative
on the carry.
Play calling. Picks up 3 yards.
That's Bainbridge were pretty confident.
Yep.
Third and about five. And in the meantime, the clock continues to tick and we're heading towards 4 minutes. And Kentwood has an insurmountable task.
I wonder if number 40, I have a Caden Krause on my roster with a different number.
That could be it.
Maybe him?
Yeah, it could be.
Ball swept outside.
Tackle for a loss. Number 22 is Jackson Zylstra. So that'll be fourth down. They'll kick it, no doubt.
So the clock continues.
Should continue.
East Kentwood used their final timeout.
Oh, okay. 3 minutes and 48 seconds. So Byron Center will also talk this over. What does Kentwood do when they get the ball back?
Try to score quick. You got to bring the ball down the middle. You got no timeouts.
Emphasis on scoring quick.
Yeah, and you got to maybe try to use the sideline to your advantage a little bit, but it's not impossible, but it's going to be a tough to do.
It sure is. I mean,
they do have, they're going to, realistically, Mark, they'll probably get the ball somewhere around the 30, between the 30 and 40 yard of their own. And so they'll have to go 60 plus yards.
Right.
With a defense that's going to be playing.
With a defense that knows what's coming.
Yeah, and they're going to be playing pretty pass prevent type.
Yeah.
We'll give up anything in front of us.
Deep.
Just keep them in bounds.
Exactly. Yeah, I agree.
More players are running out for Kentwood. It'll be a quick punt. If that lands, Oh, and it keeps rolling.
Yeah.
He's going to pick it up. Edmonds picked it up, saved his team some yards, but the ball is all the way back to the 15.
15-yard line, 85 yards to go just to get in the end zone. And they need three scores.
Three scores. Yeah, because
brought down by Jackson Zylstra.
Well, Byron Center, the up front guys can basically turn her loose and rush the passer here. And as Ron, as you said, the defensive backs, the safeties are going to drop way deep and keep everything in front of them.
You should tackle them in front of you, try to keep them in bounds. A little pass prevent. The key is don't let nobody behind you. They're going to let them, yep. That's a good catch.
Yep. Out to the 30, that's a 15-yard gain real fast.
That's Holt on the reception.
Stop by 22, Jackson Zylstra.
Zylstra on the tackle.
For a Falcon.
A nice look at the full moon coming up over across from us, Mark.
Beautiful. Watch for Byron Center to jump one of these routes, too, right here. They've shown the ability to do that early in this game. And they're going to be looking for an opportunity to do it again.
Penetration up the middle. He's open. Got him behind. Oh, in defense.
Yep, there's a great defensive play. Number nine. That is Andrew Croft. We have said his name before. Excellent defensive play that time.
Boy, speed closed that gap.
Oh, yeah.
Guy got a step on him, but
tipped it just enough.
Just enough.
Just enough to.
So it'll be, is it fourth down? Second down.
Second down and 10.
Second down. Yep. Pressure up the middle. Flushes him out. He's looking. He's going to have to do something.
Yep.
Oh, and he
gets drilled by number 51. A good, clean hit. Hudson Pulaski. Made him pay for that little scamper.
But he picks up a first down, so four new downs. But downs isn't the problem for Kentwood right now. It's the clock.
Yeah, and they're down to right at 3 minutes when this ball snapped. Now they get a blitz in there. Chase him out of the pocket. Here's another throw way down the field, and it's picked off. There's that jumping of the root. Number six got it. Landon Conrad.
And then we're going to, on top of that, we're going to get an unsportsmanlike flag against Kentwood. So they're going to gain add 15 to that. I think he might be. He took a shot at a guy.
Okay.
So here's the interception right here. He just airs this out and
Conrad jumps the route.
Yeah, he's just playing center field back there.
Yep.
And
here's that hit before.
Yeah.
Good clean hit.
That's a clean hit.
Yep.
The result of the play was an intercepted pass. Personal foul. Unnecessary effort. Offense. Number 53. The penalty's declined.
So they decline the penalty, and they'll take possession of the ball.
That's going to just basically just about do it for this game.
Yeah.
Kentwood is now faced with an insurmountable task, and Byron Center has the luxury here of just grinding it out and running a few plays, and basically Kentwood can't stop the clock anymore.
No.
We're at the 2:55 mark.
So it's just going to be two hands wrapped around the ball.
Number 40, yep.
Bainbridge
carry.
On the carry.
Stop by 57.
Nothing fancy. Just
Deontay.
Punch it up into the line and keep your arms around the ball.
Tyler.
They'll run the clock, play clock down as low as they can. And really need a couple more snaps here.
Make sure it's milking.
again, Kraus picks up a couple yards, maybe one or two. Doing exactly what they want. Get that clock to run down.
Yep.
So this ball will be snapped on third down with about a minute and a half left. They can then run it down inside of a minute and if they decide to punt. They don't get a first down here, so. Again, the Byron Center came out in that first half with a really good offensive approach.
Did.
They were throwing the short pass, they were moving the ball, and then here in the second half, they've just gone back to their bread and butter of burning clock, and boy, he's gonna get a first down.
Yeah, he
is. That's gonna do it.
Yeah. That'll allow Byron Center to run off the clock.
The Kraus with the runs and gets a first down. And Kentwood will probably have to, or the Byron Center have to run another play.
You're absolutely right, though, Ron. They came out with a solid game plan, a balanced attack, running and passing, especially featuring the short pass. They played great on defense. I was so impressed with their defense, basically all the way through this game, but especially in that first half when they were just tough on the pass. And they
really capitalized on every opportunity that was given to them.
Every opportunity, every turnover, every big play went Byron Center's way.
Yep.
So
one more snap here, and this is gonna do it.
Well, while we're at it, let's just say all our best to both of these two teams as they head into the deeper into the season and into conference play. And congratulations to a wonderful effort on the part of the Byron Center Bulldogs.
Yeah. So as the teams meet at half, we'll just take a break. Mark, we'll be back to wrap this one up. Again, final score, Byron Center 33, East Kentwood 16.
For me, things were getting pretty rough, so I made a list. I figured out what habits I should be doing more of and less of. More things like this, less of this. More this and less of this. Make your own list of good things to start doing more of and bad things less of. It can work. For more ideas and getting yourself in a better place, visit yourlifeyourvoice.org.
We're back here as the two teams meet at the traditional handshake at midfield. A stellar performance,
yeah, sure
as a way to put it, by the Bulldogs. We talked, they capitalized on the mistakes that Kentwood made, and they put points on almost every single time.
Yep.
They came out, I thought, with a very good offensive game plan coming into the game to start. They mixed it up really well. Even though they got hit with the injury bug a little bit, boy, guys stepped up and made plays. A couple of very impressive plays. The defense was rock solid from the guys up front to the safeties in the back.
Yep.
Guys making play after play after play. On the other side, East Kentwood, they just couldn't get it going.
Yep.
They had some spurts in there. Casey Joppy threw the ball well a few times, but they just couldn't get the rhythm going. The turnovers just killed them tonight, and they just came up short. But again, this Kentwood football team is to be reckoned with. They go to Hudson. They play Hudsonville next week. Again, we talk about this OK Red. Hudsonville's a rock-solid team.
Yeah.
You know, good teams playing each other week in and week out. Coach Tony Kimbrough and his staff will make some adjustments. They'll be ready for the Eagles come next week.
I think so, too.
So they come. Now they're 1-1. See, start. Byron Center now goes to 2-0 into the OK White. I don't know, Mark, if I'm in the OK White, I'm not anxious to play them right now.
No.
I don't know about you.
No.
So
no.
Look out for them. Again, like we said, guys came in that supposedly under the reserve, backup players, but they didn't play like backup players.
No,
they played like first teamers from start to finish. A couple of players out there, a lot of experience, you could see it, and guys stepping up, making big plays at big times, and that's what I like to see.
I was impressed with Laska. And I was impressed with Otto, of course.
Yep.
We hope that Tungate is not seriously injured and can come back soon. But I was very impressed with Wobbin as well, the second stringer. He's back out there walking around, so I think they just kept him out for precautionary reasons. But
a couple guys up front, too. Nolan's Stubblefield made a couple of big plays across that front line.
Their DBs were solid.
Andrew Croft made a couple of big plays. We talked about him all night. Isaac Lee.
Yeah. Oh, Lee.
Played extremely well.
He sure did.
He could go off and on.
Glad you brought him up because he had a whale of a game.
And a couple of guys go on the Kentwood side. We talked about special teams over there. Amon Edmonds did a great job returning the ball. Stellan Bowman had to be close to double digits in tackles. Mm-hmm. He was doing his thing. Hayden Holt made a couple of things, catches. Gordon showed up. Guys played well. The Falcons just came up a little bit short tonight.
Yeah.
So, again, we want to thank our outstanding team tonight as they brought this to you, our camera people, our people in the truck. It's just been a really fun night. I want to thank Phil Van Zigeren's been with us as our spotter, and I want to thank my partner Mark Bergsma for meeting with me tonight. I'm Ron Schultz. Again, thank you for joining us here for high school football, WKTV Sports. Have a good night.
Our Game of the Week is made possible in part by Palermo Pizza, serving the community since 1962. Family owned and operated, online at palermo-pizza.com. Palermo, home of the 24-inch pizza.